Hello everyone, welcome to all. This is Dr. Vignesh Parmeka, Assistant Professor of Geography, Government Degree College for Women's Autonomous. Here we shall discuss about the part 2 of wind system, and in this we cover the following points. They are the classification of winds. In that we focus on the planetary winds, periodic winds and local winds. Part of planetary winds, we focus on the trade winds, westerlies and polar winds or easterlies or polar easterlies. And as a part of periodic winds, we will learn about the monsoon winds. Local winds, part of local winds, we will discuss about land and sea breezes, mountain and valley breezes, hot winds and cold winds. Now let us move to the classification of winds. For ages, man has observed that in some areas of the earth, the winds blow predominantly from one direction throughout the year. In other areas, the wind direction changes with the season, and in still others, the winds are so variable that no pattern is discernible. Despite these differences, the winds are generalized under the following 3 categories. They are permanent winds, or primary winds, secondary winds, or periodic winds, tertiary winds, or local winds. The figure on the screen discloses to about the pressure winds and the associated planetary winds. Now we will look into the primary winds or the planetary winds. The planetary or the permanent winds blow from high pressure belts to low pressure belts in the same direction throughout the year. The winds blowing almost in the same direction throughout the year are called prevailing winds or permanent winds. These winds blow over vast areas of continents and oceans. These are also called as invariable or planetary winds because they involve larger areas of the globe. The planetary winds can be divided into 3 types as the following. They are trade winds, westerlies and easterlies. The 2 most significant winds for climate and human activities are trade winds and westerly winds. Firstly, we will look into the trade winds. The trade winds are those blowing from the subtropical high pressure belts towards the equatorial low pressure belt areas. Therefore, these are confined to a region between 30 degrees north and 30 degrees south latitude in both the hemisphere throughout the surface of the earth. The word trade has been derived from the German word trade, which means track. To blow trade means to blow steadily and constantly in the same direction. I repeat, to blow trade means to blow steadily and constantly in the same direction. Because of the Coriolis effect, the northern trade winds move away from the subtropical high in the northeast direction. They flow as the northeastern trades in the northern hemisphere and the southern and the southeastern trades in the southern hemisphere. Trade winds are descending and stable in areas of their origin, that is subtropical hydrogen belts, and as they reach the equator, they become humid and warmer after picking up moisture on their way as they are moving on the surface of the oceans. The trade winds from the two hemispheres meet near the equator, and due to the convergence, they rise and cause heavy rainfall. The eastern parts of the trade winds associated with the cool ocean currents and are drier and are more stable than the western parts of the oceans. In the southern hemisphere, the trade winds diverge out of the subtropical high towards the equatorial low pressure belts from the southeast direction, as the trade winds tend to blow mainly from the east. They are also known as the tropical easterlies. The figure on the screen discloses you about the location and the movement of the trade winds. Trade winds in the north hemisphere are northeasterly trades, whereas in the southern hemisphere they are known as the southeasterly trade winds or southeast trade winds. We will look into the westerlies. The westerlies are the winds blowing from the subtropical high pressure belt areas towards the subpolar low pressure belt areas. They blow from southwest to northeast in the northern hemisphere and northwest to southeast in the southern hemisphere. In the northern hemisphere, they are known as the westerlies, as well as in the southern hemisphere. The westerlies of the southern hemisphere are stronger and persistent due to the vast expanse of water, while those of the northern hemisphere are irregular because of uneven relief of vast and land masses. The westerlies are best developed between 40 and 60 degrees south latitudes. These latitudes are often called as roaring 40s, furious 50s, and shrieking 60s, the dreaded terms for the seas. The poleward boundary of the westerlies is highly fluctuated, and these winds produce wet spells and variability in the weather. Now, the third type of planetary, the polar easterlies. The polar easterlies are dry, cold prevailing winds blowing from northeast to southwest direction in northern hemisphere and southeast to northwest in the southern hemisphere. polar easterlies are those winds which move out of the polar high pressure belts towards the subpolar low pressure belts. There are no regular winds blowing from the north polar region. Moreover, the polar ice is not considered to be a quasi-permanent feature of Arctic circulation. However, there are prevailing outflowing winds from the Gideon. In the winter, easterly winds are observed from the anticyclones in Siberia and Canada. But on the poleward sides of the depressions that form over the North Atlantic and North Pacific, the easterly winds do occur. The winds in polar regions generally blow from various directions and they are largely controlled by the local weather disturbances. The polar easterlies blow from the high pressure polar areas of the subpolar lows. The polar easterlies of southern hemisphere are rather more coherent and well defined. Easterly winds blow out from the anticyclone formed over the high plateau of eastern Antarctic. The Indian Ocean near the Arctic Antarctic coastline experiences such easterly winds. Needless to say that the little is known about the atmospheric motion in high latitudes. Our knowledge about the atmospheric conditions hardly extends beyond 70 or 75 degrees north latitude in the northern hemisphere and 60 degrees south latitude in the southern hemisphere. Whatever we know about the meteorological conditions in high latitudes is very sketchy. Now, we look into the second type of winds. The secondary winds are the periodic winds. These winds change their direction with change in seasons. Monsoons are the best example of large scale modification of the winds. The word monsoon has been derived from the Arabic word mosim, meaning season. The winds that reverse their direction with the change of season are called monsoon winds. Monsoons are traditionally explained as land and sea breezes on a large scale. They were earlier considered as a convectional circulation on grain scale. The phenomena of monsoon winds and their characteristics, the reversing circulation used to explain by the differential heating of land and water. It was also ascribed to the seasonal shifting of tropical and subtropical wind belts. But there are certain peculiar aspects of the monsoon circulation, such as its worst to sudden transition from dry to wet season and the vagaries of rainfall associated with it, which cannot be fully explained by the aforesaid causes. Hello. The monsoons are characterized by seasonal reversal of the wind direction. Nowadays, the monsoon is generally accepted seasonal modification of the general planetary wind system. During the summer, the trade winds of southern hemisphere are pulled northwards by an apparent northward movement of the sun and by the intense low pressure core in the southern, in the northwest of the Indian subcontinent. The Asiatic monsoon. The Asiatic monsoon is the result of interaction of both planetary wind system and regional factors, both at the surface and in the upper troposphere. While crossing the equator, these winds get deflected to their right under the effect of Borealis force. These winds now approach the Asian landmass as southwest monsoons. During the winter, these conditions are reversed and a high pressure core is created to the north of the Indian subcontinent. Diverging winds are produced by this anticyclonic movement, which travels southwards towards the equator. This movement is enhanced by the apparent southward movement of the sun. These are northeast or winter monsoons, which are responsible for some precipitation along the east coast of India. The monsoon winds flow over India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, the Arabian Sea, the Bay of Bengal, the Southeastern Asia, Northeastern Australia, China, and Japan. Outside India, in the Eastern Asiatic countries, such as China and Japan, the winter monsoon is stronger than the summer monsoons. So far, we dealt with the following points. Classification of winds. In that, the planetary winds, the part of planetary winds, we focused on the trade winds, westerlies and easterlies. We also focused on the secondary winds or periodic winds. As a part of periodic winds, we looked into the monsoons briefly. In next session, we will focus on the tertiary winds or local winds in detail. Till then, take care and stay safe. Thank you.